fired.
No.
Yeah, you're fired. No. Take you and your people, crawl back to the goddamn bottle and live in it, man, because I won't take you.
Hey, come on, man. You want some?
Yeah. Let's have a big hand for the Hanford High School Band! That was great, kid. Great. Well, everybody, this day has finally arrived. And you all remember as well as I do how a few years ago, everybody was saying this town would never be anything but a farming town.
Enjoying the speech? That's the mayor. Mayor Goodman. He's just a real windbag.
Is that right?
Yeah, I've only been working for him for about a week. Construction foreman, but I don't think I have ever met a guy so in love with the sound of his own voice.
I know the type.
No, he's a typical politician, you know, always trying to act like they're doing it all for you. And you just know this cat's got a big piece of this deal.
He does. His family owns the land.
An even brighter future to add to our illustrious past.
See? There you go.
Yep.
You from around here?
Once.
My name's Dylan. Dylan Hale.
I'm Claire. It's nice to meet you, Dylan.
You got a last name, Claire?
Claire?
Oh, hello, Dad. Claire Goodman. Excuse me.
Well, didn't know you were coming back into town.
I wanted to surprise you.
You certainly have. It's a hell of a long time to go without a phone call or a letter.
Well, you've been quite busy in my absence.
Say, Hale. I heard you were having some kind of problem with that Thompson boy.
Well, not anymore. I just fired him.
You know, that boy's daddy and I are pretty good friends, if you know what I mean. So, I think the boy deserves a second chance, don't you?
Sure, okay.
Good man.
Yeah. Goodman.
Nice to meet you, Dylan.
Oh, yeah.
You just got back into town. Don't you think it's a little bit too early to start making new friends?
I just talked to the guy.
About what?
About you.
I know what you're capable of when it comes to men, Claire. Don't you goddamn embarrass me.
Embarrass you?
You know what I mean.
Well, would it embarrass you if I invited him to dinner tonight? Because I did.
Oh, you just never do stop testing me, do you, girl?
Not until you pass. Hey, Dylan! Wait up.
So why didn't you tell me who you were?
I did.
No, I mean before I got my foot crammed down my mouth.
Because then I wouldn't have had the benefit of your brilliant political insight.
It's very funny. So did you tell your dad what I said about him?
Yeah, I did. You know what he told me to tell you?
Mm.
You're fired. I was just teasing you before. My father really likes you. He does. He wanted me to invite you to dinner tonight.
Really?
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. He respects you. He loves anyone who's a good kiss-ass.
Danny, did you get your job back?
Shit, yeah. That fucker Dylan gives me a hard time. My old man will have his ass. You know why?
Why?
Because he don't miss his homeboy. Yeah. Come on, give him.
Woo!
Yeah!
Shouldn't we put it back?
Dylan, do it, dickhead. Go!
I'll be there in a minute. Nature calls. Hope you don't mind a little irrigation, dude.
He's shooting. It was all around me. Did you see it?
You're wasted, man.
Let's get the fuck out of here.
God. Have another beer.
Showed up. I'm flattered.
I'm only here to impress your father, remember?
Come on in.
By the way, you look beautiful.
So do you. Why don't you let me introduce you to my family? This is my Uncle George.
How you doing?
Uncle George is the one who's been farming our land all these years.
Hey! Boy, looks like you need to drink. As does anybody who works for my big brother.
I hear you.
This is my Uncle Thaddeus.
How you doing?
His wife, Barbara.
Hi, how nice to meet you.
Hello. Our daughter, Stephanie.
Hi.
Hope to see you in church.
Yes, sir.
Dylan. This is my Uncle Frank. He's our town sheriff. Here we go. Uncle Frank, Dylan.
How's it going?
This is also Toby and Martha and his lovely wife, Lorraine.
Well, hi there.
Well, glad I got a chance to meet you. Like to know the folks hanging around my town.
Why don't we go have a drink before he arrests you for loitering?
Sounds like a good idea.
Let us pray. To give thanks that we undeserved spoilers of this planet can enjoy this rich bounty. Though others may be cold, hungry, homeless, and diseased, we must remember in the midst of this richness that the appearance of goodness is not always what it seems. The scriptures warn us that beneath the shining skin of the ripe fruit lies pestilence, vermin, and rot. So, Lord, we thank you for your kindness in giving us, undeserved as we may be, this fine feast. Amen.
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 Oh, is that fresh corn?
It's actually corn from Uncle George's farm. But I suppose this is the last year we'll be having this.
Claire.
I'm just saying I'll miss it, that's all. I mean, those crops have been amazing. Year in, year out, it's the best field in the county, whether there's a drought or a freeze or...
Claire, if you're so damn sentimental, where have you been for so long?
Come on, guys. We all miss the farm, but it's worth it. It's great having Claire back.
Yeah, so let's cut the crap and turn stuff in our faces.
Going out?
I told Uncle George I'd stop by and visit before it got too late.
Is that the truth, Claire?
Jesus, Dad.
Thank you.
bitch!
I know you're in here, asshole!
Why George pick a time like that to work on his damn machine?
Frank, George was drunk. He'd been drinking like that ever since Dorothy died. I mean, an accident like this was bound to happen.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
Uncle Frank, there's something I have to tell you. When I was going into the barn, I saw something.
What?
Well, I'm not sure. At first, I thought it was a man standing on the edge of the cornfield.
A man? What did he look like?
He was tall. He was wearing these weird clothes, like some bizarre costume. And then it was like he wasn't a man.
What do you mean? Wasn't man?
I don't know. He moved so strange, and I was looking at him, and then he was just gone.
Claire, you've been through a lot. You need some rest. Let's just get on.
No.
One minute.
Frank? Frank? You just get out to the car. Come on. Let's go. What the hell are you trying to do? She's been through a lot.
I'm the sheriff, Bill.
She says she might have seen something. I gotta check it out. I'm a cop.
Frank, don't. I know how you feel. You want to believe that there's something that you can do. But being a good cop isn't gonna bring George back. It was an accident. What the hell else could it be? How do you feel?
Groggy. That plea gave me really knocked me out. Oh, God. I've been out all day.
It's good. Needed the rest. Sweetheart, look. About what you thought you saw, it's impossible. I mean, you were just upset and your mind was playing tricks on you.
I know that I saw something.
Honey, nothing can bring George back.
Well, what if it wasn't an accident?
It was.
You don't know that. You're just worried about me embarrassing you. It's not just you. It's this whole town. Everybody is so concerned with appearances. It's like they're protecting some nasty little secret, but nobody knows what it is.
I don't know what you're talking about, girl. Claire, don't go out.
Right now, I think I just need some fresh air.
Sweetheart, I really don't think you ought to go out by yourself.
Why? I mean, it's perfectly safe. Unless I have an accident, right?
You look like you just saw a ghost.
Are you just back there following me?
No, wait. Somebody's following you? I don't see anybody.
I don't know. I think I just need a drink.
Hey, Danny.
Hey, what?
Look who just walked in.
Hey, Claire. Hey, Dylan. You looking for me? Wanna maybe finish what you started yesterday?
No. But, you know, someone was mixing it up with one of my graders, left it out in the field. Now, you don't know anything about that, do you?
Are you accusing me?
Jesus, what is the legal drinking age around here? 10?
man.
Hey! My uncle's dead! Show some respect!
Sorry, Claire. Come on.
See you around, Dylan.
Oh, yeah. You're gonna see me around. Count on it.
I'm counting on it.
Are you all right?
Yes. I'll see you in a while.
Where are you going?
To the church. I need to make arrangements. Poor George. Funeral services. Stephanie, would you like to come to church with me?
No thanks, Dad. I'm gonna go to bed. I'm really tired.
Come over here, child. This arrived in the mail for you today. I am not too happy about this. We need to have a talk.
Good night,
Father. Good night.
Disgracing in this honor in this holy place. Sweet Jesus.
He maketh me to lie down in the grave. I shall not walk.
Where's my book? Speak now or
sit.
Thanks for helping me get through tonight.
Well, you know, the night's not exactly over.
I don't even know you yet.
What do you want to know?
Tell me what you want from life.
I guess I'm just looking for what everybody else is looking, you know? Somebody that's gonna be there in the morning.
That shouldn't be too hard to find.
You'd be surprised, you know? I'm just not the kind of guy that women stick around with. You know, they use me, then they lose me.
Well, from what I hear, that's what every guy wants from life.
Yeah, I guess I'm not every guy.
No. You're not. Lucky thing for you that I came into town.
Really? How lucky?
I haven't decided yet.
Well, how long does it usually take you?
Depends on the guy. Okay. I've made up my mind.
Let's go out. Someplace where no one can hear us. Someplace romantic.
I guess that'd be okay.
You got a couple bucks for beer?
Shut up. He's gonna hear us.
Sit tight, babe. I gotta get me a tall, cool one.
I thought that's what I was.
No, you're the short, hot one. Oh.
time he got back.
Thompson's body. This van was found with blood all over it, and his body was torn apart like something inhuman had gotten hold of him.
Frank, this is getting out of control.
Damn right, it's out of control. Two, maybe three murders in the last two nights, and it's not being done by a homeless man. It's not being done by a man at all.
Frank, get a hold of yourself. You're starting to sound like Thaddeus.
I don't care what I sound like. I'm trying to do my job, Will.
Then I suggest you stop listening to ghost stories and go after the obvious human suspect.
Hon, who would that be?
That'd be Dylan Hale. You saw the fight he had with Danny yesterday. Then Ben tells me they damn near got into it tonight at the tavern.
But that's real convincing evidence, isn't it?
Frank, sit down. As always, let me spell it out for you. You're the sheriff here, because I'm the damn mayor. And now, I am about to close the biggest land deal in this town's history, and we can't afford to look like a bunch of hicks letting murderers run around loose, or monsters. So you do your damn job, little brother. You arrest the son of a bitch and close the case.
You know what it sounds like to me, big brother? It sounds like you're more interested in your land deal than your family.
Something feels weird with my family. I don't know what it is, but I gotta go.
I'm going with you.
Oh my God!
Jesus!
What?
Oh, shit. Right.
Do it.
Hold still. I'm almost done. This is the last one.
Thank you. Hey.
Going on?
Where's Stephanie? Has he taken my daughter? Has he claimed her? Oh, of course he has. She will not be spared. None of us will. None of us will!
Tell me what you're talking about.
He has come back.
Who has come back? Come back for what?
For generations we've been trying to forget when we should have remembered, prepared, prayed. It all began over 100 years ago. When the Goodmans founded this town, they came west looking for a better life, and when they arrived here, they found more hardship. Drought, frost, pestilence. The ground was hard, soil devoid of nutrients. People were starving. Disease ran rampant. Old Silas Goodman was the spiritual leader. The people came to him and asked for his help, but there was nothing he could do. And then this stranger came. He was a man of magic, a man of evil. In Hanford, he saw a land of opportunity. Came to Silas and offered him a solution, a bargain. He would make the earth fertile, the wells run rich, the weather temperate, the crops grow bountiful. The price was simple. In this town,
the warlock would have complete freedom. Freedom from persecution, freedom to do as he liked. Freedom. At first, all went well. Town prospered, and the warlock prison seemed harmless. But Silas Goodman was a God-fearing man. He knew he had made a pact with the devil. A devil he could not control. The warlock was a hedonist of the First Order. He took over the town, not by force, but by pleasure. He lured the young girls into Witch's Sabbath, which turned out to be nothing but wild orgies. Seduced Silas's own daughter. Silas decided it was time to stop this, no matter the price, and stole his book of magic spells and turned his own magic against him. One night, Silas drugged the warlock. At dawn, Silas and townspeople dragged the demon onto the field. They'd cut a stone slab that would seal his tomb. They chopped a path deep into the corn. When the warlock realized what was going to happen, he started to scream and threaten. Even as they lashed him to the cross and crucified him. It took the warlock 2 screaming days to finally die. Our people burned the body, put his charred bones into the special casket, burying them deep into the ground. As long as the bones remained undisturbed, the people of Hanford would be assured rich harvest for all time. Each generation would erect a scarecrow as a reminder. Our ancestors thought this tomb was sealed forever. Now, somehow, the warlock spirit has escaped. As if we'd brought the evil on ourselves.
So how do we stop it?
The secret is in his book of spells. It was given to your father as firstborn of our generation. What he's done with it, I don't know. The spell that would destroy the warlock is in that book.
Okay, Dylan, you better get him home. I'm gonna go to my father's and find the book.
I'll get your uncle home. And you, be careful.
Thaddeus, tell me. What's gonna happen if he finds the book?
He can reunite his spirit with flesh. He will become human again.
If that happens, no one can stop his power. No one.
Jesus.
Where's my book?
Thaddeus, is that you?
Come on, Mills, let's get you down here. You want something to drink? Coffee? I don't know what you got here.
Something. Tea. I'd like some tea.
Tea. Tea it is.
Rot with the worms!
Drop this?
Put it down. Raise your hands, Hale.
Come on, sit.
Just do it! Come on. I'm taking you in for the murder of Danny Thompson.
What, are you out of your mind, man?
Shut up!
Look, you gotta talk to Thaddeus about this. He's got some ideas about what's going on, all right?
Where is he?
He's upstairs. I just brought him home now, you know? I mean, I was just making him some tea, for Christ's sake.
Okay. Let's go find him.
Dad, you in there?
Look, I know he's in there. Maybe he's passed out.
Come on.
Where do you think you're going?
We gotta get to Claire's house. She went to talk to her father and...
What are you doing, man? You know I didn't do this.
I don't know anything, man.
You know that you're not going anywhere.
Until I do. If you don't hurry, they're all gonna be dead when we get there.
Frank, we have got to find the Warlock's book.
You have any idea where it might be?
It could be anywhere.
All right. One minute. When we were kids playing in this house, Will told me about a secret hiding place in the attic. He said if anything ever happened to him, there was something real important up there.
Okay, let's go.
No. I'll look. You go outside. I got Dylan in the car.
No. I am not walking away from this.
Okay. There's a trap door in one of the floorboards in the attic. Here, hold this a minute. He said I'd know it when I saw it.
Okay, come on up. Help me move it.
Emily! Mother!
Physical connection between the warlock spirits and the bones. If we destroy the bones, then he's dead forever.
They were buried in the field when they crucified him.
Look out, Claire!
Listen, please, we need your help. He's right behind
us. Stop right there! Move to the front of the car, put your hands on the hood.
Get your ass out of here right now.
Just get in your fucking car. It's gonna be right here.
Shut up! Where's the sheriff?
He's dead! Listen, if he gets his hands on this book, this town is fucked!
Shut up and put your hands on the car!
Would you just fucking listen to us?
No, you listen to me. You get your hands back on that vehicle, or I'm gonna shoot you in the fucking head!
Don't go back there!
Teddy, go check that out.
I wouldn't do that if I were you!
Go on.
Bolt cutters. We gotta burn his bones, right?
Fire.
I got something better than that. This shit'll melt through rock at room temperature. Liquidate that fucking bastard. Wait. Get that hatch.
Thank you.
Come on, give me the flash. Hold my legs. Hold my legs. I see something. Drop me lower. Lower. Can't reach. Come on, lower.
Come on! Ah! 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 Ah!
You okay, Ray?
Are you okay?
Claire?